Hi guys, welcome back to another tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how you can use Beauty Retouch for retouching. So first thing first, what we're gonna need here to do is go to background, duplicate the background, rename this clean or cleaning as you want. We go here and click spot healing brush or patch tool. So we're gonna work with these three tools. I'm just gonna start with healing brush. And I'm gonna start to clean. As you can hear from the sound, I'm using Vacuum Tools Pro S. It's a really nice vacuum to use for retouching. I highly recommend this to you guys for into retouching. I mean, like, quiz for serious, not just for fun, because sometimes retouching can be for fun. I'm talking about for people who want to use for professional purposes. It's highly recommended from all over the world retouchers. It's a really nice tool to use. As you can see, is better than mouse or mice, as you wish to say it. I'm using it for months now and it's been very helpful for me. You can check my old videos, like 1 year or maybe 2 years before I use the mouse, and since I switched to Wacom Intuos Pro, it really changed my life for better, of course. It has been my workflow, and they are not that expensive. You can find them for like 100-200 bucks, something like that. Depends on the country where you are living. In my country, Kosovo, it's like something like 300. This one that I'm using. If you're living in US, UK, I don't know, Europe, you can find it for like 100 or 200, something like that. I don't know for sure. But it's worth the price. So as I said if you're a pro into retouching, if you want to become pro, or you're just starting to work as a retoucher for others, I highly recommend this, because it will make your workflow very fast. As you can see, let me switch from pen to mouse. As you can see, clicks, as you can hear, sorry, it's just like, I don't know, I can't change it anymore to mouse, so let me switch to pen. So enough talking for the vacuum into us. Let's talk about retouching. I'm just doing some general cleaning, nothing spectacular, as you can see before and after. One thing I do every time when you guys are asking me in comments, like, what's the top layer you do, it's a duplicate background layer. I rename it this SOOC. It means like straight out of the camera. It's a original file, as you can see. I leave it on top so I have to check before and after. This is a nice thing to do, why not? As far as we've done is cleaning, so I'm just gonna merge them. And we're gonna start working with Beauty Retouch. One thing, many of you guys work with frequency separation and dodge and burn, so some of you been asking me like, which one is better, frequency or dodge and burn? Well, If you like frequency separation, go with it. If you like blood jumping, go with it. If you like both of them, go with them. So let's just start working with 8-bit. For the radius, let me check. You have to zoom in and zoom out every time before you slide that radius. So I think I'm just gonna go with 8. Yeah, 8 is good. Let's put this straight out to camera on top. Go to low frequency separation. Duplicate this. Create a clipping path. Yeah, clipping mask, sorry. And for low frequency separation, as you can see, the low layer, I'm gonna work with mixer brush. For mixer brush, I use wet like 15, load 15, mix something like 25, and flow 20 or 22, something like that. And just start working with mixer brush. I think I'm not gonna remove the black dots, something or things like that. I'm just gonna go around them. As you can see, I'm mixing the skin tones. Mixer brush is that tool that makes skin tones, highlights, shadows, and make them really smooth. I use frequency separation and dodge and burn most of the time, like both of them. There are people who use only dodge and burn. It's okay. Why not? Using them both, it's a really nice thing to do. It will create something magical, I would say. Because it would turn the images into something really, really nice. Let's see before and after. As you can see, guys, let's zoom out a little bit. Before, after. Yeah, let's just start working more here. For my opinion, this image, this portrait, is not in that much need of retouching. I'm just gonna work as slow as possible. I'm not gonna go hard on this because working too much in one portrait or one image or one picture, sometime it will destroy it. As you can see, I'm mixing some highlights here. Sometime I destroy them. Sometime I'm really good at it. Depends on the mixer brush that I use. If I go hard, sometime I destroy them. If I go soft, sometime it's good, sometime not, but you have to work for that. There is no just one click and bam 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 bam, it's all done. No, you have to go like part of part. As you can see, I mixed some skin tones. As you can see, I have destroyed some here, here, something here, but I will fix them with dodge and burn. For low, I think we are done for the moment, so let's just go to high frequency or texture. Let's just duplicate that, change blending mode to normal, and create a clipping mask. Is a copy of this, it just original. I will keep this original, so if I do something wrong here, I will have a copy. So just work on the, sorry guys, on the duplicated layer. I'm just gonna work with clone stamp tool. you can use a spot healing brush or healing brush, it doesn't matter, but let me demonstrate you what spot healing brush does to texture. As you can see, let's just remove this. It will create some, I don't know, some kind of blurry parts, which is weird, and I don't like it. If you use a healing brush, which is hardness too much, spacing 1%, and as you can see, it's good, but not good enough as a clone stamp tool. So let's just use it. As you can see, I will use a clone stamp tool to clean the texture. You have to go soft with clone stamp tool because it's a copy paste, like from this to this, from this to this, and if you copy from this to this, from this to this, as you can see, it will create a bad texture. So you have to go like in similar parts, like this to this, this to this, something like that, and not from here to here, because as you can see, it will create bad texture. So you have to be careful and work slowly, work smooth, and it will create something good. We have something here, so I have to fix with mixer brush. This nail too. But I think I will work on it later. As you can see, only with a low frequency separation, and it has disappeared like 50%. And just keep cleaning. Now, one thing I wanna tell you guys, that every time when you work on Adobe Photoshop that is not bald, it's a crack. You have, if you wanna save your time, like if Photoshop is crashing, if the power goes off, something like that, you always have to save this as a PSD. So let's just me save this as PSD. So if my power goes off, my work will be saved. So thank me later for this. And let's just wait before it's saved. It's okay. Let's just keep cleaning with stone stamp. Clone stamp tool. I'm working like 10 years or more with Adobe Photoshop, and I never can remember their names. I'm just kidding. I'm just having like bad pronouncing words because I know them all, of course. I'm just cleaning. I'm just cleaning the texture. Sorry for that. I'm not used to talk that much, so my throat goes dry. Sorry for that. Let's just check what you've done here. Check, sorry. Before and after. I think we are good so far. Let's just keep cleaning the texture. We have something here. If you wanna save time, like going zoom in, zoom out, I highly recommend this. You go to window, you go to arrange, click new window for the file name, go again to window, arrange, and choose two up vertical. So as you can see, it will create two windows, but it's the same file. If you work here, it's gonna appear here. So this is highly recommended for everyone who is having just one monitor, as you know, so I didn't have to zoom in, zoom out, zoom in, zoom out. I'm just gonna close this to have more space. I have a 24-inch monitor, but it's okay. If you have a, I don't know, a smaller monitor, I highly recommend you to guys to get a bigger one, because the more space you have, you will feel more comfortable on working on it. So go with 24, 27, something like that. And always go with a bit expensive monitor, because the cheaper ones have bad colors, something like that. They are not good for eyes. They will destroy your eyes. This is a Retina eye care display, so I will link the link below in the bio section, so you can find it. But I, like me and many retouchers, work with BenQ monitors, like 32 inches, something like that. They are kind of expensive, of course, but they are really, really good for retouching. So if you own a big company of retouching, or you're like making like too much money with retouching, or you are just, you know, if you just have the money around, why not buy a BenQ monitor and thank me later, of course. You can find on Google, just Google it, best monitor for retouching 2021, 2020, something like that. And you will find a list with cheap, expensive, budget, something like that. I think we are done with frequency separation here, before and after. I think we have something here. Of course, let's just fix that. As you can see on the left side, before and after, if you have something that you need, as you can see here on the neck, I will work just on low. Yeah, it's low problem. Here is the texture problem, so I'm just gonna work on high frequency or texture. You have to clean the nose here, of course, so just go correcting to the correcting tones folder. Let's just zoom in, click eye, and copy the color here. Because if you do here on the empty layer, it will do nothing. So just go to the low layer, maybe to the original file layer. Just go to correcting tones, click B for brush. If you don't have B, you will find brush here, opacity and flow. Change it in the way you want to work. And just fix. The nose, as you can see, it's not appearing that much because we have texture layers up, so they are stopping it from fixing it. So just gonna put correcting tones here. I think I'm just gonna go with a darker brush. And fix this. It's too much, I think. Yeah, for sure. Just create a mask. Work on it. Yeah, it's good. Just keep working the nose with mixer brush. Here's something. One thing I do on the texture layer is I work with mixer brush too, so it'll smooth up the harsh textures, like something like that, as you can see, guys, before and after. I think we have to work a bit more in this part with brush, of course. I'm just gonna paint it over, so I will make the nose look a bit good, nicer, something like that. Sorry for that, too many stories. Let's just go to the other one, make it a bit darker. I think it's good. Nope. Let's go to the texture, work more, clean the nose, and yeah, I think we are good. Yeah, sure. One more thing for the frequency separation, as you can see, so we have something here, just work on the texture. And yeah, we are good with frequency separation. Let's just go to Peter Touch. We have to work with Dodge and Burn, of course, but we have to click on the I don't know, let me check. Visual aid. Yes, it's a visual aid. But we have first to click on Dodge and Burn curve setup. So it will create a Dodge and Burn and a helping layer. So let's just go to Dodge. Click before brush. Click visual. This one, it will create a black and white help layer, so you have to, you don't have to zoom in, zoom out, you know, to check colors. So black and white layer will help you. I'm just gonna make it a bit darker, something like that, maybe. No, let's just create another curve, which will be black. Sorry, not it'll be black, but it'll be darker. Go to the Dodge, go with the flow like something. Many people go like opacity like 100 and flow something like 1, 2, maybe 3. But you know, you can go with whatever you want. So just go play it around, go B for brush. As always, you have to check this left left side for not zooming in, zoom out. So let's just work with Dodge. Let's just brighten some parts. I think we need something here, something here. For me, dodging burn is a helpful thing to do, because something you can't achieve with frequency separation, you can do it with dodge and burn. As you can see, I'm just dodging some parts that need to be dodged or to be brighter. As always, check left window for work that we are doing, and just have higher flow and dodge more. Just check before and after. Yeah, it's a nice thing. Just keep working. You can see we have to dodge more here, so I'm just gonna zoom in a bit more. as you can see, guys, some before and after. I just turn this off and put the straight out camera always on top. As you can see, before and after what you've done. So just keep working with dodge and burn. You have some parts that need to be burned, of course. Usually on when I work, I have more like parts that need to be dodged, not to be burned, but you have to work with both of them. So you will create a nice balanced Let's just check before and after. Yeah, we definitely need that. Let's just go to just move around with layers groups. As you can see, before and after. Yeah, I think it's really good. This is like a Dutch local. Not global, so I'm just gonna duplicate this, turn this into black, and go B for brush and work. This was like local, you can name this local, and this is global. And just work with brush. I think we have to go with a bit higher brush, yes. As you can see, we are creating some nice highlights. I'll just check before and after. Yeah, I think it's good. Just here we have to fix it because we went too much. Lower the opacity and I think we're good. Same thing goes for the burn. I just renamed this local, this one global, and sorry, make it all black. Oh, sorry guys, and start working on some shadows, on some dark parts. As you can see, check before and after. Yeah, I think it's good. As you can see, we have some bad burn here. I'm just gonna remove it, work on it again. I think it's good. Just low the opacity so you don't have to make big things. You have something here that need to be fixed, of course. You can fix it with in low layer with mixer brush. Yeah, I think it's good for the low, so let's just work with texture. Yeah, I think it's good. As you can see, before and after of all this work, I think we are done here with frequency separation and dodge and burn. Save this, of course, every time. One more thing I want to do is work on eyes. So let's just go click on magical eyes. wait before it's saved. Yeah, go to Magical Eyes. Wait for this. Put this under, of course. And it's saying clean whites here, so I'm just gonna go click B for brush and start working on this. As you can see, it will remove the veins and the red color on the white of the eyes. And I think we are good with the brightening. If you think it's not that brightened, you can always go to the group folder here. So we'll just click on create another curve and make it brighter. As you can see, I think we went too much with the brightness, so let's just lower the opacity of this and see where we have worked. So I think I'm just gonna brush out something like that and something here. I think we are good for the whitens. If you think that this is too much, you can always lower the opacity. So I'm just gonna do that. This one says add light to iris, so you have to click before brush and start. I think the opacity of my brush is too much, so I'm just gonna go back and click 1 for 10 and work on the iris. This one makes iris whiter, as you can see, before and after. Yeah, I think it's really nice. Let's just lower the opacity to like 16. This one says add light to eyeball. As you can see, we can add more light to the eyeball. Yeah, I think this is too much, but it's looking good. Why not? Let's just go lower the opacity, something like 30. This one says darken iris outline. That means that we have to work on this one. It will make it darker, as you can see, before and after. Yeah, it's good. This one is only for dark areas, so if you want to work on here, you can do that. Why not? Oh, sorry, I think I have this right. Let's just go to history, go for brush, something here. Yeah, I think it's good. As you can see, I think we went a bit too much, so just lower the opacity always. This one says change iris color, so it's for changing the color of the iris. You have to paint over the iris first. As you can see, it will change the color. So the guys who made the beauty touch left it to blue, so you can see what you have done here. So if you want to change the color of the blue like into something different, you can always click here and change the color, of course. I think we are good with blue if you want to change the color. And you have to work with opacity here, so you have to go like 10, 20, something like that. But I think green is good for me, so I'm just gonna go with 2, something like that. And we are good here for the magic eye. Let's just check before and after of everything. Yeah, I think magic eyes are a bit too much, so just glow the opacity. And this is really good. We go to magical smile. This is for teeth, of course. We can something that too many people use here is that they go with magical skin tone. This is a really nice tool from Beauty Touch. Let's just check what does. We'll make this whole layer mask whiter. So as you can see, it will create some nice skin tones. I'm just gonna go make it black again and start with brush, B for brush always, unless you change it to something different. As you can see, I'm painting on it only on the skin tones. You have to brush it slowly because you don't wanna, you have to brush it slowly because you don't wanna work on lips or maybe eyes, because it will change the tone of the lips, as you can see. We have worked only for the skin tones, not the lips and the eyes. So let's just check before and after of this one. Yeah, I think it's really good, but I think it's a bit too much into yellow skin tone. So let's just lower the opacity of this to something like 50. Yeah, I think it's good. As you can see, before and after this whole process, I think this video is very helpful for you guys want to use Beauty Retouch, and thank you for watching. Don't forget to comment, subscribe, leave something, a note, something good. If this video is helpful, if not, let me know in the comment section. So see you guys in the next one. Peace.